We are now done with the net operating profit in the free cash flow formula. The second term is the change in net fixed assets. The only fixed asset Manoa has is property, plant, and equipment. To estimate the change in net PP&E, we will estimate net PP&E in 2018 and 2017, and then take the difference. Luckily for us, we do not need to estimate net PP&E in 2017 because we have this number. It is in the 2017 balance sheet. So we only need net PP&E in 2018. To do this, we will use another well-known financial ratio, the fixed asset turnover ratio. This ratio is defined as sales over net PP&E. Let me first show you this ratio for Manoa, and then I will explain how to think about it. The table below shows the fixed asset turnover ratio for Manoa for the years 2015, 2016, and 2017. As you can see, this ratio ranges from 13 to 13.5. What does this ratio mean? This ratio tells you the dollar in sales Manoa generates for each dollar in net PP&E. Think about it this way: Manoa uses presses to punch cans out of aluminum coil. Imagine the only fixed assets are the presses. A higher net PP&E correspond to more presses. The more presses Manoa has, the more cans it can manufacture, leading to higher sales. In our case, this ratio is fairly constant, so we will use the average of this ratio, 13.23, to estimate PP&E in 2018. Let me show you how to go from this ratio to the estimate of net PP&E. We assume that fixed asset turnover in 2018 is 13.23. This is defined as sales in 2018 over net PP&E in 2018. Since we know sales and the ratio, we can solve for net PP&E. So now we have net PP&E in 2017 from the balance sheet and in 2018 from our estimate. Note that we are forecasting an increase in net PP&E. This makes sense. Since we are projecting higher sales, we need to project a higher level of net PP&E, that is, more machines, to be able to meet this higher sales level. Finally, we take the difference between net PP&E in 2018 and 2017, as this is what we need to compute the free cash flows. I would like to make a few comments about the fixed asset turnover ratio. This ratio measures how efficiently a firm uses its fixed assets. A higher number would imply that more sales are generated per dollar of fixed assets. For Manoa, this ratio is roughly constant. However, this is not always the case. If a firm is not operating at capacity, it can increase sales without the need to invest in more equipment. This will show up as an increase in the fixed asset turnover ratio. This is likely to be the case in industries with important fixed costs. Think about the telecommunication industries. Firms in this industry invest a significant amount in infrastructure. Initially, utilization is low, and it increases over time. Another reason why this ratio might not be constant relates to the size of the firm. It is possible that as a firm becomes bigger, they also become more efficient. For example, this is true in the manufacturing of airplanes. Economists refer to this effect as increasing returns to scale. In terms of our ratio, increasing returns to scale implies a higher ratio as the firm grows. As you can see, different firms would require different assumptions. This is not a one-size-fits-all type of exercise. You really need to understand the firm and the industry you are analyzing.